Bob, you mentioned in your first weather, the humidity, and we're in fall, and you just can't even really tell because it's just so hot.
Yeah, I mean, fall doesn't count for us in Florida. I don't think mid-October is when we start to see our first cold front on average, but even looking at the long range, there doesn't appear to be any strong cold fronts headed our way. One thing tonight, though, it was amazing. Spectacular sunset out there. We had these clouds called Mimantis clouds. And they're upper-level clouds. It's air sinking at the top of the storm. So it's actually associated with big storms that are around, and we had those. Whenever there's a tornado, typically you see Mimantis clouds, but it doesn't necessarily mean that you have a tornado when you see Mimantis clouds, but that was our tower cam right there from the Van Wezel. That's what Van Wezel showing the nice, beautiful sunset. Here are the pictures now. Had many, many photos sent in. And you can see the puffiness of them right there. They look like cotton balls, or if you will, udders, and they're called mammary clouds, really. Judith sending that one in. Andy, get a look at that. Is that spectacular or what? It just looks like they're coming down. It's actually air sinking at the upper level of the cloud, and the air around it causes the smoothness to occur right there that you see. Shelly Smith Rodriguez sending that one in, and Julie Blank, right before sunset, you can see some of those again right there, and they were seen for over hundreds of miles now across the Sun Coast. Titan radar picture showing this storm right here continuing to head toward the Carolinas. The rain not all that intense. It's still going to bring some rainfall there during the morning hours. Eventually this is going to take off to the north and then to the northeast. Should not be a big factor. It suppressed the high to our south. We're getting more of an east to southeasterly wind, and that really fired the storms up again near the sea breeze. It didn't get far inland today, similar to what we saw yesterday. I think the same goes on tomorrow and possibly even into Thursday. Some storm is still building around, even along Siesta Key. Some light rainfall there. A shower or two east of I-75 near Clark Road. And some showers down into Charlotte Harbor. Boy, the rain was heavy for the second day in a row. Over 3 inches of rain just east of Englewood. Also into Port Charlotte. Some very heavy rainfall there. Northport, to the west of Northport. Near Warm Mineral Springs, 1.25 inches. And had quite a bit of rain in Manatee County, too. This is 6 hours, but about 8 hours ago. The rain was over Palm View as well as into Palmetto and Ellenton. Now, the forecast, future cast, these are how models can sometimes be not that accurate. This is actually initialized right here at 12 o'clock in the morning, showing a large thunderstorm there, but that's not going to happen. We're going to see some rainfall around, but nothing that strong. And then we'll see generally fair skies overnight. Drop off for kids should be great. Your commute, no problems weather-wise. And then by the afternoon, once again, showers and storms building. Some of those could be strong at times, and they could linger in through the evening and then push on out. So the summer pattern continues. I don't think it changes much on Thursday. Similar conditions. Friday may be a little different. That's good news for football Friday night. There may not be as many storms around. I mentioned this low pressure area continues to spin, and there was some deep convection earlier, but that is starting to wane somewhat as it moves off to the northeast, or northwest, I should say. And we have this particular guy right here. This is the remnants of Kirk, and boy, it's really fired up. What appears to be near a center, National Hurricane Center, giving this a real good chance of developing into a tropical depression or storm. I think it already looks like a tropical depression or possibly even a storm. Here's some of the forecast paths and tracks of that system right through the Caribbean. Now, normally, in a normal year without El Nino, very concerned about that, but the upper level winds are expected to be strong, high shear, and so it probably won't last its journey through the Caribbean, as a lot of the other storms haven't either. But we'll watch it nonetheless. Upper 70s, low 80s, a warm and muggy night right now, current conditions. We're looking at 77. Heat index not a big factor, but the humidity is at 96%, the dew point at 76. So for boaters, not much going on out there in the morning and early afternoon, but later in the day, those winds and seas will pick up. We'll have a light chop. The forecast then, a good chance for scattered storms the next couple of days, in the afternoon and evening mainly. And then a slight chance for showers and storms. There'll still be a few around, but I don't think the coverage will be as great on Friday through Sunday of next week. And then temperatures remain unseasonably warm in the low 90s all the way through Tuesday of next week. Where's fall, right? Jacqueline?
All right. Thank you, Bob.